Did you just find out that your spouse, your foreign spouse, who just married and got her a green card, used you for that green card? Well, what can you do about it? Watch this video and I'll tell you more. In this video, we'll go over what a US citizen spouse can do when they find out that their foreign spouse just defrauded them just to get a green card. My name is Jacob Sapochnik and I'm an immigration attorney based in San Diego, California. I've done thousands of green card cases over the years, and sometimes it happens that the foreign spouse will get their green card and things will happen and the US citizen will find out either through direct information or indirect information that that spouse used them to get a green card. And we get calls like this all the time, whether they are our clients and or are people that are not our clients, and they find my YouTube videos and go find me on Facebook, and they just want to know what they can do. So typically, if it's my client, and we represent both the US citizen spouse and the foreign national, I will always tell them that because I represent them both, I can't provide information because it will be unethical. So typically, I would probably refer them to somebody else. But the ones that come to me and I have not done their case before, we try to figure out what the situation is and what kind of fraud it is. So for example, if it's a situation where it clearly is a fraud, where that person paid somebody to meet that person, or they find out that they, as soon as they got the green card, they went back to their original boyfriend that they had, or things like that. You know, the first thing that you can do is, as a US citizen, is alert the USCIS, the Immigration Service. It's your right as a US citizen, especially as a sponsor. You are now the sponsor on their application for the next 5 years until they become a citizen, 3-5 years. It is your duty to at least notify USCIS as to what you find. Remember, there's no way for a US citizen to just call somebody and then they will revoke a benefit, a green card. It just doesn't happen like that. And the reason is because otherwise there will be too much abuse. But if you have enough evidence, if you document it in the file, and you can write a letter to the USCIS and state, this is what happened, this is why I feel that this was a fraud case, I only found out right now and I feel defrauded. Because what's going to happen is that typically, there'll be a divorce filed, the US citizen, you can file for a divorce to divorce that spouse, and at that point, as you know, when they get a green card, and if the marriage is less than 2 years, it's only a conditional green card. And so, typically a US citizen can divorce the foreign spouse, and so it will be much more difficult for them to renew their conditions to get the green card beyond the 2 years. Now, it's possible for them to still do it, even without the US citizen, but it's going to be much more difficult at that point to do it. And especially if you write a document explaining in a logical, not a vengeful way, but in a logical way as to why you believe it was fraud, then the USCIS will take this into account when they interview the spouse in 2 years to determine whether they qualify for the benefit or not. And so I've been present in many interviews where I went, I represented the foreign spouse, and part of the questioning, the US officer would pull a document and says, hey, your US citizen spouse sent us this letter, I want to verify a few facts in the letter. And again, if they're able to see that these are just angry statements, there's no truth in them, they'll still get the green card. But if they find out that some allegations are not correct, it will make it very difficult for the foreign national to get the green card, and that's pretty much all you can do. There's nothing, you cannot just go ahead and take away the green card, you cannot, we never recommend anybody just to do those things to spite, but if it was in fact a fraud case and you find out that they took advantage of you, it is your duty as a US citizen to at least notify the authorities, and it's going to be up to them to take action. That's it on that. If you have any questions, please post them in the comments below. Make sure you share this video with somebody that may need that, and subscribe to our channel and click that bell over there to notify you when a new video comes out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.